Parliament's Foreign Affairs Committee is probing allegations that the land titles of Uganda's mission in Pretoria and ambassador's official residence went missing. Today they interfaced with Andrew Nyumba, the acting secretary of Uganda Land Commission, who informed the committee that although he had received a similar request from the Minister of Foreign Affairs to provide a copy of the titles, the search through the commission's records yielded nothing fruitful.
I talked to the current, I think it's the accounting officer, Ambassador Paul Amoru in Pretoria. Ambassador, yes. He told me that he has never seen those titles.
Nyumba told legislators that both the current and former ambassadors denied knowledge of having ever seen the documents at the time they held office.
I also talked to the former accounting officer, Ambassador Sarah Nakamia. She said in all her tenure there, she never saw these documents. And she also referred me to her predecessor, Ambassador Julius Chivuna. And he also said the same thing, that they have never seen any of these documents.
We have got very many properties for our missions. Is it only this one that is missing for Pretoria? Do you have the rest of the certificates of the properties that we own as a country in those other missions?
There are some that we have. Unfortunately, I've not come with a list of those that we have in our custody.
The committee's probe into the matter followed a directive issued by the Deputy Speaker of Parliament, Thomas Tayewa, at the start of November 2023, where he directed the committee to give details in regards to information provided before Parliament. Committee members went to South Africa and they were told that the titles are with the Minister of Foreign Affairs, which also came to deny custody of the said land titles.
I am failing to understand. If the Ministry of Foreign Affairs, which has the responsibility and mandate for our foreign missions, clearly tells this committee that a high commission in Pretoria, which owns property 882 Church Street, Acadia, and 083 Pretoria, that the land deed issued in 2001 is in possession by Uganda Land Commission, and you say you do not have it. So what kind of controversy is this?
Legislators also registered concerns that some officials in the Ministry of Foreign Affairs have started intimidating them against probing the issue of the missing land titles and vowed never to produce the titles unless Parliament secured a court order.
The ministry was really, really tough. Even the minister himself told us here, I think some people are my witness, Shizia and Kathy, he was very tough on us and said, we are wasting our time.
I said, you're going to be investigating.
We are investigating nothing, and we are also going to be investigated why we went to South Africa.
If it is indeed true, and we have the records, that the minister uttered that statement, Madam Chair, that is intimidation.
MPs claim that Uganda's High Commission in South Africa borrowed money without authority of Parliament and mortgaged the two land titles.
The investigation has stretched to now identifying the relevant properties. From the onset, it was heard and referred by Parliament to the committee that investigation be done as to whether there was acquisition of a mortgage illegally without approval and consent of Parliament, and as well under which terms.
The committee chairperson gave the Uganda Land Commission up to Tuesday next week to furnish the committee with a written response about the missing titles in South Africa, as well as produce a list of all the land titles from the other missions abroad. Report compiled by Fred Kajubi for the news at Parliament.